actually what I was trying to do is actually making a search engine, a different type of search engine, which does images, text, audio, video as well. So the prototype that I made, it actually, it searches, let's say, now it is working on a predefined image directory. Later on, it would probably be working on, let's say, video feed, live video feed that is coming from security cameras or road cameras. And essentially, given an image of a person or a number plate of a car or both together, it can monitor and track those people or cars. So this was one part of it. But essentially what I'm trying to do is, so NIA actually uses a software which is actually sourced by IBM, which helps them whatever intel or whatever information they have gathered across different parts of the country to assess them together. But it is just like searching through files and folders. What I'm providing is actually an AI-based solution, a search engine, where you can do all those things, as well as you can do real-time tracking and monitoring of people and objects. You combine those things to actually speed up the search process. For example, in Bombay, we had
can you divide into the two parts, basically? Basically, we are dependent on almost what is coming into the possession of the police accidentally, right? I will explain. Say, you captured something from scene of crime or some nearby CCTV cameras, etc., right? And in majority of the cases, culprit will try to cover and camouflage his face, and he will try to distort to the extent possible, right?
Yes.
Now, instead of depending on this accidental kind of whatever we could capture, right? Whether it is live, photo, or whatever, right? Can we make it little more systematic? What do I mean by systematic? Let me explain about that. Basically, whether it is a vehicle, all target object. In normal course of their functioning, we intend to capture 360 degree of each one of them, right? And let it go into a database, right? So, I mean, whatever you have done, that is wonderful, and that will be certainly usable, and we will see your live presentation, and probably we will have a you share your email ID, and what I will do that we will have a team meeting, right?
Yeah, sure.
And that we will be holding after 5th of October, because I am busy before that, right?
Yeah, okay.
So that you can get sufficient time to really prepare and react to that. I am having a design basically to have additional cameras should be mounted in a target areas. So you must have realized that majority of the criminals, I mean barring few smart criminals, those who have bigger one. So barring few of them, majority of the people, they live in a concentrated area. We can say criminal cluster. Right. Especially the people, those who are getting involved in a small kind of petty offenses, right? And as you understand that every criminal, he might become Dawud Ibrahim later on, right? But sometime he is also a small player, right?
Yeah.
And generally he will living into the cluster area.
Yes.
Area which is maybe the slum area, maybe an area which is preferred by the criminals, right?
Yeah.
Now, we intend that using public, because anything which is being owned by the government, it will never be behaving efficiently, right? It may not be functioning properly, and it will be having a lot of overhead costs. And on the top of it, basically, we intend to involve more and more people to distribute them revenue, right?
Okay.
So, the people around the cluster area, so there could be the two kind of the things. One is the criminal cluster, and the second is the hot spots. Hot spots means the area where crime is committed, right? So, these criminals come and they identify which is the best area where they can target their victim, and they can fetch good value out of it, right? With the least risk involved. Now, there could be the concentration of the CCTVs with the participation of the local people, maybe chai wala, this wala, hostel wala, or even we can plan. Later on, we will have the gumtis and we can association with the Nagar Palika, Nagar Nigam, etc. We can even create those kind of the facilities. The purpose is to capture the feed from there, right? Now, we want to capture face expression, gesture, their gait, right? We want to capture even their what apparel they are wearing, right? Even if they are basically spectacles and things like that, right? Now we want to maintain a rich library for each criminal and their associates.
Yes.
And then we want to really categorize even the mood part of it. So, presumably they have committed a crime, and there's a likelihood that the person either he committed the crime and he is enjoying his booty, or he is likely to commit crime, right? Now, there could be n number of attributes to infer about it, right? The timing would be one and n number of the things, right? Even a facial expression kind of the thing. Now, from that library, we want to go into the predictive dimension, right? That this person is going to commit crime, right?
Okay.
Right. So we want to capture that face expression, timing, associates, right? They intend to move. We would like to capture that which are the vehicles and things in which he is moving, right? Those kind of the things, right? Then we will discuss. So those kind of the things we intend to do, right? Now, then one is we will predict that what route he will be likely to adopt, right? Now, we can make use of his CDR to basically generally people go for the survey and things like that, right? So, we know that which could be the target area, right? And we can even go into the intervention.
Okay.
Right. And say, assume career now the crime has been committed, we could not really prevent it. Then from there, sometime we may not get the right kind of feed. But if we are having 360 degree of everything, then we can very easily and with the higher level of confidence, we can connect the criminal, because we are having the details about each component of that criminal, right? We know his gait, we know his face expression, we know his kind of that cloth he is having, right? Rather than library, we can say that this cloth has been noticed for the first time, right? Now, this kind of the vehicle has been noticed for the first time. And from there, we can even infer if how he could have really purchased that, right? Is it a purchase from the proceeds of crime? Now we are changing the whole dimension, right? We are trying to go in a predictive dimension. So these details would be available in our library, will be gathered over a period of time, not connected with any crime. Now some crime has been committed and we could get some glimpse, and which may not be that much clear, then we can look, okay, these could be the people, then we can say anticipate this could be the route, and we can have that n number of the nodes from that those nodes we can get the feed, right? And we could look for the corroborative evidence. And if we could do this job smartly, probably we can get the n number of the field to connect when he started, with whom he has started, in which vehicle he was moving, with what speed he was moving, and which route he has followed, right? And whether he has changed his cloth and route, whether he has, after committing of the crime, whether he has changed his vehicle, whether he has changed his cloth and things like that, so that police should not be in position to catch him in Nakabandi and things like that.
Yeah.
How do you appreciate this dimension, and how confident you feel that this kind of the dimension could be created with your level of expertise?
Yes.
Yeah,
so actually, like you said,
you feel it doable?
Yes. So prediction of crime based on expression is something that expression.
No, it will not be one. It will not be one. There could be n number of the attributes which could be used in conjunction to predict. Say, if you want to commit crime, then there will be a certain kind of the timing, right? You will be moving with a certain kind of the vehicle, with certain kind of the preparation, right? Mm-hmm. It means if we get one thing which could be indicative, there's a likelihood, then we will look for the other dimensions as well, other attributes as well, right? And when we will find that many attributes are really joining and in collective, or we can say that, yes, he is likely to commit crime, right? Now, in my mind, whether we could have the predictive intervention strategy, right? Which route he could be lying, what could be the target area, right? And no crime, criminal commit crime ad hoc. He will be visiting that area, he will be making some kind of the preparation, right? So, his earlier movement and movement of his associate in particular area and say adjoining hotspots might give, say, suggest few hotspot where he is likely to attack.
Yes.
Is it making sense?
Yeah. So the next thing that I was making was actually acquaintance analysis. So given an image of a person and given live feed from all the cameras, can you classify that a person usually moves along or gathers with which other people, and then you can search on those people to create an entire network of who meets who and who meets where. Another thing that can be done easily is you can actually use acoustic sensors to actually listen to what people are talking, microphones, and you can do text analytics. He can probably talk in any language. We have libraries that can actually work up to 127 languages. So he can talk in any language, say whatever he say, and we can perform advanced text analytics to actually decipher what he's doing. And we can also do a profiling based on voice as well, as to who is he, what is he saying, what places are subject, what is the subject of what he's talking. So it can be video feed as well, it can be audio feed as well. Just if, let's say, there's a restaurant and you can just put microphones, and we can perform that degree of analysis as well, as to who is talking, what is happening. If they talk about, let's say, performing a crime, we can perform text analytics and we can predict that they are talking about something. They are talking about breaking the law, doing some robbery or something, and we can actually bring that into the main network as well, along with text, along with images and videos. And this entire thing can be integrated into one solution as well. So that level of integration can be done. This can also be combined with gate. So this system can be built slowly over time in bits and pieces. First we cover videos, then we'll cover audio, and then we can actually build up a complete system. So as of now, what I read is that NIA uses IBM system, and that has limited set of users. It works on a similar concept of nodes and gathering intel and actually doing collaborative search, but it doesn't perform any AI-based functionalities. We can add those as well to build a better in-house system and a cheaper one as well.
Great. See, what we can say what is doable today and what we can add on as we progress, right?
Yeah.
because yes. We have to really create some kind of ecosystem to make it happen, right? As yes. your network of the public will be growing, right? So even yes. though 137, say let's presume that every member of the population or set, right? Yes. They are connected with us and they are the part of the CFP, right? Crime Free Bharat yes. Volunteers. Yes. So once the ecosystem would be created, implementing these things will become easier, right? Yes. And we can have the judicious mix of everything. Human-driven, fitted kind of sensors, a sensor yes. being operated through, even we can say, through drones.
Yes.
They may be the human body-borne sensor sensor, right?
Yes.
Sometime it may be known to a person and some other time it may not be known to the person, right? But that will depend upon how that we are progressing, how our capacity is building, right?
Mm.
Say sometime we yeah. can even make it happen that way, that a particular thing which is having secret sensors, that may be presented through a network to the concerned person who is our target. I mean, then we can even plan to that, right?
Yeah.
They are reaching out and entering into the inner coterie is more challenging. It is life-threatening and maybe risky, right?
Yes.
But that kind of the potential capabilities we would be creating in due course of time. So we have to start absolutely simple model and then we can say, okay, these are the add-ons which we would be introducing as and when we feel that we are ready to introduce them.
Okay.
Yes. Achha, secondly, I would like to know your other competence area now. Because yes. I don't know whether you are you following the Crime Free Bharat YouTube channel?
No, I'm part of a group, so I'm actually seeing what all happens in the group. So,
lot many things are not really uploaded or posted in the group. Because the YouTubes are having much more input than we are posting it in any group, right?
Okay.
Because if we will do that, it will become overdoing kind of the thing. Because the creation at the end of the YouTube is much higher.
Hmm.
So much so that lot many things are still waiting to be uploaded.
Okay.
So yeah. I will recommend you if you can really. Subscribe Crime Free Bharat YouTube channel and after going through how you can technologically contribute to make it happen. And while doing so, you may not be alone. You can identify the like-minded people, even your seniors or juniors or who have might have started a startup or something like that. Because this initiative, now we have created a full ecosystem. There's a CFB Agro Initiative, there's a CFB IOS Initiative, there's a CFB Transport Initiative, there's a CFB E-Commerce Initiative, and there's a CFB Infotainment Initiative, there's a CFB, Nari Samman Initiative. Because what we feel ki we are only trying to attack on negative dimension of the scenario. Mm. Okay, for example, the pornography, it is distorting our value system. They are getting a lot of money, so even TV serials and pictures or movies, they are also being deliberately made by making use of the money flowing from the India breaking forces, from D company kind of people, right? And they are putting a lot of money and a lot of distortion is being taking place, which we are not realizing. We take the things at the face value, whereas flower, कोई पिलक तो कर रहा था तो so what we can do, we can really create a kind of the ecosystem. And we are going into the model of abundance. I feel that I am having the pathways, and basically those pathways are not mine. Basically, these pathways are having some cosmic origin. Basically, some strange things happening to me. Every day, I get some idea, some download from cosmic origin, right? Which tells me, do this, right? And I try to really reduce that in writing so that I should not forget it, right?
Hmm.
Now, I am trying to create an ecosystem, and I feel probably that's how that India is going to change, including how to remove criminality from Indian politics. I think day before yesterday, we launched another, launched in the sense we created another dimension, that is the CFB expenditure free election.
Expenditure free.
So basically, purpose is this, that you are not allowed to meet anybody one to one for canvassing. You cannot, that will be a crime basically. Because you are a public figure, right?
Mm-hmm.
So a public figure should talk like public, right? So whatever you want to tell to your prospective voters, you should have a strategy. You will be given opportunity to have n number of the videos. They will be routed, and we will be having a reach so that we can reach out to each and every citizen of India, right? And it will be given into the area which is your like prospective area where you have to, the people have to bid for you, right? So then there will be analytics that what you are you stand, right? Then you will be exposed that you tell me how you will be meeting out expenditure. So a responsible politician would be created, right? And then there will be the debate would be, and then probably the voting may be through app. I'm talking of the futuristic vision, right? Where these, you have to see through and through, only then you will get that option to vote. Otherwise, it will say you have not build all the Johanna things about the candidate, right? So candidates' criminal record, candidates' performance in Vidhan Sabha and Lok Sabha, then what he claimed as a part of the canvassing, then his interface with the public and learned group to face question and answer, right? So now that will become very responsible voting. When the people are transacting so much of the money through the e-commerce, why we cannot do our voting through that same platform? It is doable. How much the colossal waste of the election is being done, a lot of crime is being committed, a lot of brutal force are being used. So India will become a different place to live in. And this should basically should become our passion, that we have to make a difference in our country. Otherwise, we have to live with this slogan ke Bharat mein kuch nahi ho sakta hai. Ye to aise hi chalega, yahan ke neta to aise hi hain, yahan to bureaucrat aise hi hai, yahan ki to police to aise hi hai. So now we have to really think ki whether we want to live whatever is being provided to us, or we can contribute in transforming it. And you listen to the other, our agro model, we are saying that we will be creating so much of the wealth that India is going to be a very wealthy country. I am saying that the family, those who are workers, right? Those who will be workers in the field, those family would be getting something like 2 lakh rupees per month. It's a happy money.
Oh.
Basically, I would like to first go through the various videos. Then we can have even the discussion on the various modules of the CFP.
Okay.
And then I can really, I mean, being a smart person, I would like to really invite your input and your views. And I really look forward for the people you feel that competent to really do the partnership. And everybody would be beneficial, because basically we will be handling ecology, we will be handling that negative bombarding of the chemicals, right? At present, if we are not woke up, almost 100 population of the India after 5 years would be getting involved in cancer related matters. So 2% out of the 3% would be suffering from cancer or autonomous diseases, and 1% would be attending them. It means almost 100% population will be directly or indirectly involved to via the consequences of the cancer. That will be a phenomenal cost to the country. What is the psychological impact? What will be the stress impact? What will be the financial impact on the country? And who is bothered about you? Everybody want to mint the money. So no, I mean, people are busy in creating big jo hai fit for to so that you should fall. Hum ek dusre ke liye maut ki gadde khod rahe. And we are creating a really very negative ecosystem where the things are going to deteriorate. So you will be surprised that 42% of the parliamentary MPs, they are having criminal record. Do you know this?
42%.
Yes, it's a very big number. And progressively, all political parties, they are preferring the people with the criminal record because their vulnerability is higher. It means if no intervention is brought in, then 2024 parliament would be having more than 50% people with the criminal record. And then I said that it will be no more a democracy, it will be criminalocracy, government of the criminal, by the criminal, for the criminal. Police bhi unki hogi, kanun banane ka power bhi unka hoga, governance bhi unki hogi, apna keval chutar hoga, danda unka hoga. Aap meri baat samajh rahe na? So if smart people just a minute, if smart people join together, probably we can make a difference in next 2 years. That's why I have come out with so many TFB's initiative, not limiting to the crime-free Bharat, not talking only on the 5 certainties which I was talking earlier, that is reporting certainty of registration of FIR without visiting to Thana, certainty of detection by the most ordinary police officer because of the backup support, backup engine of the crime-free Bharat, then coming out to help out the judiciary. So that present more than 4 crore cases, they could be dissolved in next 2 years, and then we can ensure that conviction within 15 days. At present, it is very unfortunate that even in the case of the Prime Minister of the country, you are taking 20 years, 25 years, and things are in very, very bad shape, right? Now, this things has to be reversed. Then we were talking about preventive things, that how we can have the preventive strategy so that we can intervene before the crime could take place through a smart intervention process. And finally, we say that when you are having so much data about your criminals, why you are waiting them to commit crime? Why we should not really identify the skill set, the skill gap, and go for the skill development and rehabilitate them as a good citizen? Why you want them, they should stay as a criminal? Why they should not become the productive citizen of the country? And there was five revenue streams also. And I was of the view these revenue streams will be so powerful that government would not be requiring taxation for a country to run, for the developmental activity of the country. Now we have gone for that CFB Agro Initiative and other initiative, and we are of the view that we can take away the scarcity from the nature, and we will bring back the abundance, because the abundance is the part of the nature, not scarcity. Scarcity we created because we imposed the cost and the currency. In nature, there is no cost, there is no currency. Do you agree with me?
Yes, I agree.
So I will appreciate that if you can really go through the various videos and audios and things like that. And then we can even have, first will be certainly whatever you have created, that presentation. And then I will appreciate that I would like intervention of the young brain about the other ideas also. I mean, you may not be directly connected, but I would like to capture your reflexes, your responses, it will help me to improve my own concepts.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Are you fully feeling motivated to do that?
Yeah. I'll go through the entire CFP channel. And I agree with you. Actually, for person-based profiling to actually, not just for politicians, but for people, to actually help them get a better career path is something that can be done. It is not being done. It can, these things can be done. Even in the political campaigning, electronic voting and profiling people and finding their, electronically finding their traits and bringing them in public is something that will improve transparency in the system.
Very
these
true.
Things can be done.
So, I had already created your group, right?
Yeah.
And I will appreciate that if this number 6040, right? If it is not there, you may add this number, number one. Number two, I will appreciate if you can really add a few more students which are having the same kind of the temperament and would like to contribute for the country. That will be a great journey, right?
Okay.
So I will sincerely request you if you can look for your colleagues, you can look for even your senior alumni, even you can look for the people, those who have started their startup, and if they can really contribute, and we promise they will be suitably rewarded. They will be rewarded and what they can be earning through their own initiative.
Hmm.
Okay.
Right? Yeah.
So, Asha, it's a pleasure talking to you, and we will be talking on 5th basically. 5th night, right?
Okay.
Till then, this is the preparatory time for you.
Okay.
Right, Asha, it's a pleasure talking to you. Thank you.
Yeah, it was nice talking to you as well.
Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, bye.